Welcome again to another lecture on HVDC systems. In our last lecture, we discussed converter analysis with commutation overlap, and we discussed mode 1 as far as commutation overlap is concerned, that is overlap angle U less than 60 degrees. If you remember, we have drawn the waveforms for both rectification as well as inversion modes of operation, and based on the waveforms, we derived the mathematical expression for converter average output voltage, and we made some conclusions. Some very important points were noted down. Then another mode of operation is mode 2. Mode 2 means overlap angle U exactly equal to 60 degrees, which will give 3 value conduction only. Mode 1, that is U less than 60 degrees, gives 2 and 3 value conduction, and mode 2, that is U exactly equal to 60 degrees, gives 3 value conduction. It can be understood with the help of same diagram. See, this is value 1, conduction for 120 degrees, value 3, conducting for 120 degrees, 5 again conducting for 120 degrees, then again 1. So it continues like this. So similarly here, value 6, 2, 4, 6, 2. Okay, this entire period is 120 degrees. Value 1 conducts for 120 degrees. Same is true with other values, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6. All values are on for 120 degrees. Now U is equal to 60 degrees. That's overlap angle is 60 degrees. At this point of time, 2 is fired and commutation between 2 and 6 takes place. And it lasts exactly for 60 degrees. See, from this point to this point, it is exactly equal to 60 degrees. So you can write U is equal to 60 degrees. Then at this point, value 4 is fired. And this commutation also lasts for 60 degrees. So this is 60 degree interval. Then at this point, again, you can see value 6 is fired and commutation lasts for 60 degrees. Same is the case with upper values. Previously, value 1 was conducting. At this point of time, value 3 is fired. Firing pulse is issued to value 3 and commutation between 1 and 3 starts. And this commutation is there for exactly 60 degrees. From this point to this point, it is exactly 60 degrees. So, 60 degree interval. Then here, value 5 is fired and commutation lasts for 60 degrees. So, this is 60 degree interval, 60 degree interval. So therefore, U is exactly equal to 60 degrees. Let us see the value conduction. See here, previously value 6 was conducting and 1 was also conducting. Here 2 is fired. Commutation between 2 and 6 starts. So 6, 2 and 1. 3 values are conducting. 6, 1 and 2. Then here, at the end of U equal to 60 degree, commutation between 6 and 2 is over. 6 is out, 2 is in, but simultaneously commutation between 1 and 3 starts. So therefore, in the bottom group of valves, value 2 conducts, and in the upper group of valves, 1 and 3 both conduct. So therefore, over this 60 degree interval, 1, 2, 3, 3 valves are conducting. At the end of commutation overlap interval, see, this is again U equal to 60 degrees. Commutation between 1 and 3 is over, 1 is out, 3 is in. But simultaneously, value 4 is fired here. So commutation between 2 and 4 starts. So you again get 3 value conduction. 2, 3, 4. 2 and 4 in the lower group, because 2 and 4 are, you know, commutation is occurring between 2 and 4, and 3 in the upper group. So you can continue like this. 3, 4, 5. 4, 5, 6. 5, 6, 1, and then back 6, 1, 2. So therefore, we get 3 value conduction as 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, followed by 2, 3, 4, followed by 3, 4, 5, followed by 4, 5, 6, followed by 5, 6, 1, and back to 6, 1, 2. So this gives 3 value conduction, and this 3 value conduction is there for U degrees. 3 value conduction time period. You see, this is 3 value conduction exactly for 60 degrees, next three value conduction 1, 2, 3 exactly for 60 degrees. So three value conduction is for u degrees, that is exactly equal to 60 degrees. So 6, 1, 2, these three values will conduct for 60 degrees, which is equal to u. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 5, 6, 1. So they will all, so there will be three value conduction for 60 degrees. So you can yourself draw the waveforms for both rectification mode of operation as well as inversion mode of operation for u equal to 60 degrees. I've already given you given this as an assignment to you on Google Classroom. Please try it. In case of any difficulty, you can revert to me, you can ask me the queries. So next mode, which is again a very important mode, is mode 3. Let us quickly start analysis of converter with commutation overlap in mode 3. Mode 3 means u greater than 60 degrees, but u is less than 120 degrees. So u greater than 60 degrees. So this will give 3 and 4 value conduction. 3 and 4 value conduction. To understand this, let us draw the power circuit diagram on the corner again. So this is our power circuit diagram of 3-phase 6 pulse converter. This is load current, DC current ID, and this is our load. This is the bus, load voltage VD. These are valves 1, 3, 5, 2, 4, 6. This is line to neutral voltage or phase voltage EA with line inductance L and line current or phase current IA. This is phase voltage EB with same inductance, and this is phase voltage EC with same inductance, source inductance. So this is neutral point. Okay, so mode 3 means overlap angle. U is greater than 60 degrees. The question is, why is U such a high value? Why U is greater than 60 degrees? The answer to this question is, transformer may have large leakage reactance, the source inductance is large. That is one of the reasons of U becoming greater than 60 degrees. Another reason is large current flowing through the system. Because when large current is flowing through the system inductance, it results in large U. So these factors make U greater than 60 degrees. Okay, so it can be understood with the help of same diagram. Let me draw the same diagram. Value, showing value conduction. This is value 1. This is value 3. This is value 5. Then again, value 1. Similarly, in the lower group, you have value conduction like this. Value 6, then value 2, 4, and 6, and then 2 again. So this conduction is for 60 degrees. I mean, this interval is 60 degree interval. This interval is also 60 degree interval. And this total is 120 degrees interval. That means value 1 is conducting for 120 degrees. Similarly, the other valves, 3, 5, then similarly 2, 4, 6, all valves conduct for 120 degrees. Okay. Now U greater than 60 degrees. So we are here assuming U greater than 60 degrees. From here to here, it is 60 degrees. So U greater than 60 degrees means slightly more than this. This is U greater than 60 degrees. Similarly, from here to here, it is 60 degrees. So U is greater than 60 degrees. Similarly, this is 60 degrees. U is greater than 60 degrees. So you can see here, this is U, and you can see U is greater than 60 degrees. Similarly, U is greater than 60 degrees because this to this, this interval is 60 degrees, and you can see U is slightly greater than 60 degrees. U greater than 60 degrees. Similarly, in the upper group of values, when commutation occurs, it is there for more than 60 degrees. From this to this, it is 60 degrees. u greater than 60 degrees means this. Similarly, this is your 60 degree point, u is greater than 60 degrees like this. Similarly, u greater than 60 degrees. Fine. Now let us show the value conductions. Let us first show, and let me draw these projections and then I will show you the value conductions. We can start from here. Value 1 is already conducting, and at this point of time, firing pulse is issued to value 2. I am showing control pulse or firing pulse issued to value 2. So value 2 is fired here. Then commutation between 6 and 2 occurs. 1 was already conducting when commutation between 6 and 2 starts. So 6 and 2 both are conducting. So that means during this 60 degree interval, during this interval, there is 3 value conduction. 6, 1, 2. 3 valves are conducting. Okay. Then during this small period of time, you can see here firing pulse is issued to value 3. I can show value 3 is fired here. Commutation between 1 and 3 starts. Commutation between 6 and 2 is already, you know, taking place. It has not yet ended. And at this point, commutation between 1 and 3 starts. So that means during this period of time, during this period of small period of time, 6 and 2 both are conducting and 1 and 3 also conduct, because there is commutation taking place between lower valves 6 and 2, and for this small period of time the commutation between upper valves 1 and 3 also starts. So that means in the lower group of valves 6 and 2 are conducting, and in the upper group of valves 1 and 3 are conducting. So 2 from lower, 2 from upper gives 4 valve conduction. What are the 4 valves which are conducting? 6, 1, 2, 3. 6, 2 and 1, 3 during this period. So 6, 1, 2, 3. Then at the end of this U, commutation between 6 and 2 is over. So 6 is out, 2 is in. So that means only 2 will be conducting in the lower group, but in the upper group, commutation between 1 and 3 is continuing. So 1 and 3 in the upper group will conduct and 2 in the lower group will conduct. So this will give 3 value conduction. 1, 2, 3. Then here, firing pulse is issued to value 4. So value 4 is fired here. And immediately, commutation between 2 and 4 starts. And 2 and 4 are conducting. 1 and 3 are already conducting. So this again gives 4 value conduction. 1, 2, 3, 4. At the end of this interval, commutation between 1 and 3 is over. 1 is out, 3 is in, only 3 in the upper group is conducting, but in the lower group for this period 2 and 4 are conducting. So this gives 3 value conduction. 2, 3, 4. You can continue like this. Then 2, 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6, 1. 5, 6, 1. Then 5, 6, 1, 2, and then 6, 1, 2 again. So you are, see, conduction starts like this. First 3 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, then 4 value conduction when 3 is fired, 6, 1, 2, 3. Then 3 value conduction again, then 4 value conduction. So we can start from 3 value conduction, 6, 1, 2. This will be followed by 4 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3. This will be followed by 3 value conduction, 1, 2, 3, followed by 4 value conduction, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can continue like this, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 1, 5, 6, 1, 5, 6, 1, 2, and then back 6, 1, 2. Okay, so 6, 3 value conduction followed by 4 value conduction, followed by 3 value conduction, 4 value conduction. So it is like this, 6, 1, 2, followed by 6, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 1, 5, 6, 1, 5, 6, 1, 2, and then next cycle starts, starting with 6, 1, 2. So this diagram shows the value conduction. Now the question is, for how much time is three value conduction, and for how much time interval is there four value conduction? I will write that on the side. So I can write, four value conduction occurs for how much period? Let us try to find that from this diagram. This is the four value conduction here. This is four value. You can take any interval of four value conduction. Let me take this. Four values are conducting during this interval. How much is this interval? This total time period is U. You can see this is U. And out of this U, how much is this? This is 60 degrees. Yahan se yahan tak, this is 60 degrees and this total is U. So therefore, four value conduction is for 60 minus, sorry, it is for U minus 60 degrees. Ye aapka 60 degrees. This is 60 degrees and ye aapka, this is U. So total time interval, this is total, commutation all of angle U, out of which this is 60 degrees. So you subtract 60 degrees from U, so you will get time period for four value conduction. So this is U minus 60 degrees. So therefore, I will write here, four value conduction occurs for U minus 60 degrees. What about three value conduction? What is the duration of three value conduction? Three value conduction duration, you can see from this diagram. This is immediately after this. This is your three value conduction. This is three value conduction. Now you can see very interestingly, this total time period is 120 degrees. Yahan se yahan tak. This is your 120 degrees. Out of this 120 degrees, if you subtract U degrees, how much do you get? You get this interval, and this is the time period for three value conduction. I repeat, this total interval, see, value 3 conducts for 120 degrees. So this total interval from here to here is 120 degrees. Out of which this is U degrees, overlap angle. So 120 minus U gives you this interval, and this interval is for 3 value conduction. So this is 120 minus U degrees. So therefore 3 value conduction is for 120 minus U degrees. This is very important, because when you start drawing the waveform and you draw that conduction table, you must remember that the duration for three value conduction, and you must also know the duration for four value conduction. Then and only then you can draw that conduction table, and you can draw the correct waveforms. So therefore, in this mode 3, U greater than 60 degrees, which gives three and four value conduction, three value conduction lasts for 120 minus U degrees, and four value conduction lasts for U minus 60 degrees. So with this in mind, let's go ahead. Some very important points we have to discuss before drawing the waveforms. Okay. Now, what is the commutation? So, in our last, previous lectures, whether it was U equal to 0 degree, that is no commutation overlap, two value conduction, or it was converter with commutation overlap, U less than 60 degrees or U equal to 60 degrees, which we have discussed in the previous lectures. We have always taken EBA, that is commutation voltage of value 3, as reference. Although it is not a binding on you, it is not compulsory for you that you start with value 3. We have taken uniformly for all previous lectures value 3 commutation voltage as reference. You are free to take commutation voltage of any value as reference. I have in previous lectures taken commutation voltage of value 3 as reference, and I will continue to do that in future also, including today's lecture, because that will maintain the uniformity. Okay. So, commutation voltage of value 3, if you remember, value 3 commutation voltage is EBA in 2 value conduction as well as in 2 and 3 value conduction. Let us try to see whether commutation voltage remains same in U greater than 60 degrees, that is 3 and 4 value conduction, or it changes. It's very important to see this. You see, let us assume that previously 6, 1, 2, 3 valves were conducting, and then firing pulse is issued to value 3, and this gives 4 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3. And then you again get 3 value conduction, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So before the firing of valve 3, there were three valves conducting previously. That's 6, 1, 2. And then you fired valve 3 here, and your 3 valve conduction was converted into 4 valve conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So that means before the firing of valve 3, okay, at this instant, there were 3 valves conducting previously. And what were those 3 valves, 6, 1, and 2? With 3 valves conducting, what was the commutation voltage? Was it EBA? In mode 1, you have seen, yes, it was EBA. Because there was 2 and 3 valve conduction. Because there, here you had 3 valve conduction, like you had 1, 2, followed by 1, 2, 3. 3 was fired here. Before 3 was fired, 2 valves were conducting. And 1 and 2 were conducting. That means commutation voltage of valve 3 was EBA. No problem. But here, this is not 2 and 3 valve conduction, this is 3 and 4 valve conduction. Before the firing of valve 3, previously 3 valves were conducting. The question is, will commutation voltage remain same? EBA? Let's check it. 6, 1 and 2 are conducting. 6 and 2 in the lower group are conducting. That means this valve and this valve are conducting. And 1 in the upper valve group is conducting. 1. 1 is conducting, that means your anode cathode voltage is EA, because when one is conducting, see, one is on, that means the cathode is connected to phase voltage EA. What about anode voltage? Anode is connected to, since 6 and 2 both are conducting, 6 is conducting, see, since 6 is conducting through this 6, your anode voltage is already EB. And since 2 is also conducting, you can see 2 is also conducting, and through this 2, your anode voltage, anode gets connected to EC also. So therefore, I will write anode voltage, that is VA, is it, what is your anode voltage? 2 is on, 6 is also on. 6 on means EB, 2 on means EC. So your anode voltage is EB plus EC. And EB plus EC, if you draw the equivalent circuit, you will find that EB plus EC makes your 2 times anode voltage, 2 VA becomes EB plus EC, that becomes EB plus EC minus EA. So this will give you anode voltage VA equal to minus EA by 2. This you can get from the equivalent circuit. If you draw the equivalent circuit, you will get 2 equations. Okay, you add those 2 equations, you will get 2 times anode voltage equal to EB plus EC. Why EB plus EC? Because EB, your anode is connected to EB, your anode is connected to EC also. Why EC? Because 2 is also on. When 2 is also on, through this 2, this EC comes here. So therefore, your 2 times anode voltage becomes EB plus EC, and in a balanced 3-phase system, EA plus EB plus EC is equal to 0. So EB plus EC is minus EA. So that will give anode voltage equal to minus EA by 2. What about cathode voltage? In the upper group of valves, 1 is conducting. So 1 is on. That means the cathode is connected to phase voltage EA. I already written here EA. So cathode voltage, I will write here. Cathode voltage, VK, K stands for cathode, is equal to EA. So therefore, what is value voltage? Value commutation voltage. Value 3 commutation voltage. I am interested in finding value 3 commutation voltage. That is V3 is equal to anode voltage minus cathode voltage. Anode voltage is minus EA by 2 minus cathode voltage is EA. So therefore, value 3 commutation voltage is minus 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 EA. That is minus 1.5 EA. This is a very interesting finding. This is something very interesting. Previously, in all the waveforms that we have drawn, whether it was 2 value conduction or 2 and 3 value conduction, we have found that the commutation voltage of value 3 in both the cases was EBA. But in 3 and 4 value conduction, we have found that commutation voltage of value 3 no longer is EBA. How much is this? What is this? It is minus 3 by 2 EA, that is minus 1.5 EA. So this is something very interesting. So therefore, once you know that commutation voltage of your value 3 is minus 1.5 EA, so Therefore, if you draw the waveforms, these phase voltage waveforms, you see this is your omega t axis. Let us suppose this is Ea, phase voltage Ea. Phase voltage Eb will start after 120 degrees, so it's somewhere here. This is Eb, and Ec will start after further 120 degrees, somewhere from here. This is Ec. We know that commutation voltage of value 3, in 2 value conduction and 2 and 3 value conduction is Eba. What is Eba? Eba is something like this. Eba, 0 to pi, for example. So here, for example, this is your Ea, this is Eb. So what is Eba? Eba, you know, Eba is Eb minus Ea. And here, Eba is equal to 0. When Eba is equal to 0, that means Eb minus Ea is equal to 0, which means Eb is exactly equal to Ea. And that is this instant. See, this is your Ea, this is Eb. And here, Eb minus Ea is 0. So this is the zero crossing of your Eba. The positive zero crossing. Negative zero crossing is somewhere here. See, this is your Eb, and this is your Ea, and these two meet again here. So Eba is equal to 0 here also. So therefore, if you draw Eba, I will draw it like this. This is your Eba. Yeah, upper Eba. This is Eba. Okay. But what is the commutation voltage of value 3 in 3 and 4 value condition? It is not Eba, it is minus 1.5 Ea. Okay. So where is minus 1.5 Ea? See, this is your Ea. Where is minus Ea? This is your minus Ea. It's mirror image. 180 degree phase reverse voltage is minus Ea. So this is Ea. This is minus. This is minus Ea. This is minus Ea. Instead of writing minus Ea, I will write minus 1.5 Ea. Actually, minus 1.5 Ea should be greater than, in amplitude, it should be greater than Ea, but I am scaling it. Okay, scaling it, I am showing it like this. Amplitude does not matter. I just want to show something very interesting to you. So therefore, you can see your, this is minus 1.5 Ea, and this is the commutation voltage of value 3, V3. And when we measure the delay angle or firing angle, we measure the firing angle. For example, if somebody says firing angle is 60 degrees, firing angle 60 degrees, you have to measure from the zero crossing of the value voltage, positive zero crossing of the value voltage. Previously, what was your value voltage or commutation voltage? Eba, and alpha equal to 60 degrees was somewhere here. Alpha equal to 60 degrees, and here you would have fired value 3. But now, in 3 and 4 value conduction, your commutation voltage of value 3 is not Eba. It is minus 1.5 times Eba. Minus 1.5 times Ea. So, for example, this is minus 1.5 times Ea. And when you measure alpha equal to 60 degrees, you have to measure it from the zero crossing of minus 1.5 Ea, not from the zero crossing of Eba, because Eba no longer is commutation voltage of your value 3. What is the commutation voltage of your value 3? We have just now established is minus 1.5 times Ea. So you will fire at alpha equal to 60 degrees, you will fire value 3 somewhere here. So where is minus 1.5 Ea? This is your minus 1.5, or Ea iska, this is the positive, positive half cycle, positive commutation voltage. This is the positive zero crossing of minus 1.5 Ea. So this is your omega t equal to 0. Omega t equal to 0 is not this Eba. This is your Eba. This is not omega t equal to 0. Because Eba is not commutation voltage of value 3. What is commutation voltage of value 3? It is minus 1.5 Ea, and this is the positive zero crossing of minus 1.5 Ea. So this is omega t equal to 0. So therefore, if you have to measure alpha 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 50, 150 degrees, you have to start measuring that from here. That is zero crossing of minus 1.5 Ea, not zero crossing of Eba. I hope this is clear. So therefore, if you consider, still consider that EBA is the commutation voltage. I mean, previously EBA was commutation voltage of value 3. So therefore, yahan se yahan tak kitna hai? How much is this? This is 30 degrees. So with EBA as commutation voltage, your alpha cannot be less than 30 degrees, because alpha less than 30 degrees means EBA is negative. And when commutation voltage is negative, you cannot fire a valve. You can fire a valve only when commutation voltage is positive. So alpha less than 60 degrees, alpha less than 30 degrees. This is alpha less than 30. Yahan se yahan tak 30 degrees hai. If you take alpha less than 30 degrees, what is your commutation voltage? It's minus 1.5 EA. It is negative. So when commutation voltage of a value is negative, that means it is reverse bias. There is no fun of issuing a firing pulse at its gate terminal. Firing pulse, your control logic circuit will issue firing pulse at the gate terminal of value only when commutation voltage becomes positive. That means when the value becomes forward biased, and it becomes forward biased after this. So therefore, with EBA as a reference, if you still take EBA as reference, your alpha cannot be less than 30 degrees, because alpha less than 30 degrees means commutation voltage is negative and you cannot fire a value when it is reverse biased. And commutation voltage of value that is minus 1.5 EA becomes positive only after this instant. So this is the zero crossing of EBA, and this is the zero crossing of minus 1.5 EA, and this angle is 30 degrees. So alpha cannot be less than 30 degrees. So alpha has to be always greater than 30 degrees. Okay, this is very important. Alpha has to be greater than 30 degrees means with respect to EBA. Okay, so therefore, if you still take EBA as a reference, you have to ensure that alpha, you know, delay angle has to be greater than 30 degrees. I hope this is clear. So with this thing in mind, let's move ahead. Now again, we'll do some analysis. We'll find what is the voltage across the load when three valves are conducting, and what is the voltage across load when four valves are conducting. So when three valves, let 612 be conducting. Let us start with the conduction of 612, and valve 3 is fired, and value 3 is fired at a delay angle of alpha. So that means previously 612 valves were conducting, and it is now time after alpha electrical degrees, it's now time to fire value 3. And value 3 I should write here. Value 3 is previously 612, that is 3 valves are conducting, and after alpha electrical degrees, it is now time to fire value 3. So when value 3 is fired, it gives 4 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3. So therefore, we have previously 6, 1, 2, it's followed by 6, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and once the commutation between 1 and 3 is over, you will again get 3 value conduction, 1, 2, 3. Let us now draw the equivalent circuit when 4 valves are conducting. So I will write for 4 value conduction, that is 6, 1, 2, 3 conduction, let us draw the equivalent circuit. Okay, 1 and 3 are odd numbered valves which belong to upper group, and 6 and 2 are even numbered valves which belong to lower group. That means when there are 4 valves conducting, 6, 1, 2, 3, 2 from the lower group and 2 from the upper group are conducting. They are on simultaneously. And which are the 2 upper valves? 1 and 3. Let us draw the equivalent circuit. So this is our line to neutral voltage or phase voltage EA, and this is source inductance L, line current or phase current is IA, and this is my value 1. Value 1 has been fired, it is on, and value current is I1. Simultaneously, along with 1, 3 is also conducting. So 1 is conducting, so commutation between 1 and 3 is taking place, it is going on. 1 is conducting, 3 is also conducting. So when 3 is conducting, that means this, the equivalent circuit will have phase voltage EB, line current IB, and this is source inductance L. Value 3 is also conducting, this is value 3, and value current is I3. So 1 and 3, 1 is on, 3 is also on, and they are in the common cathode configuration. Their cathodes are connected together. That's what I have shown. And then I1 plus I3 is equal to ID, load current. And load current flows in this direction. That means this is your inductance in series with the load, high inductance. And this is load current ID. And this is the load. So current flows through the load. And then in the lower group, 6 and 2 are conducting. So commutation between 6 and 2 is going on. So 2 is conducting, 6 is also conducting. Now you can see when 6 is conducting, the cathode of 6 is connected to the anode of 3, you can see. So I will now show this is value 6 conducting, carrying value current I6. Its cathode is connected to anode of value 3. You see, cathode of value 6 is connected to anode of value 3. Cathode of value 6 is connected to anode of value 3. That's what I have shown here. And then value 2 is also conducting. Value 2 is directly connected to phase voltage EC. This is value 2. Value 2 is also conducting, carrying value current I2. And it is connected to phase source voltage EC. This is EC. And line current is IC. This is it. This is neutral. So this is the equivalent circuit of your converter during 4 value conduction. Commutation between 1 and 3 in the upper group is taking place. So 1 and 3 both are on. Commutation in the lower group of values between 6 and 2 is going on. So 6 and 2 are also on. And your total equivalent circuit becomes like this. Now what is your load voltage? I say load voltage is 0. If I write load voltage, VD equal to 0. Because you can see, 1 is on, 3 is also on, 6 is on, 2 is also on. So all the 4 valves act as shorts. So your load gets shorted through all the 4 valves. So equivalently, I can show it like this. This is EA. This is L. See, value 1 is on. I will show value 1 on. Okay. This is EB. This is L. Value 3 is also on, so I can cross means value 3 is on, and it is like this, and then this is load, and in the bottom group 2 and 6 are on. This is your value 6. Value 6 is on. Okay, it's connected like this, and value 2 is also on EC. So you can see 1 is on, 3 is on, 6 is on, 2 is also on. So these are at the same potential, all the points, because all the 4 valves are on. That means this point potential is same as this point potential, same as this point, same as this point. So therefore, what is load? You can see load is short circuited. It is shorted by all the 4 valves. So load voltage is 0. So that means during 4 valve conduction, which 4 valves we have assumed to be conducting? 6, 1, 2, 3. You can take any 4 valves. For 6, 1, 2, 3, same is true with other 4 value conductions. So for 4 value conduction, load is simply shorted by 4 valves which are simultaneously conducting, and load voltage is 0. Fine. Now what about 3 value conduction? 4 value conduction will be followed by 3 value conduction. Let us see what happens during 3 value conduction. Now, earlier we have taken 4 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3. Once commutation between 6 and 2 is over, 6 will be out, only 2 is there. So this will result in 3 value conduction, 1, 2, 3. Now let us draw the equivalent circuit during 3 value conduction. I will write during 3 value conduction. And which 3 valves in this case? 1, 2, 3. Let us draw the equivalent circuit. So equivalent circuit will look like this. 1 and 3 in the upper group are conducting, and only 1 value, 2, is conducting in the lower group. So 1 is conducting means this is your phase voltage EA, source inductance L, line current or phase current IA. Value 1 is conducting, so value current is I1. 3 is also conducting, so I can draw equivalent circuit like this. This is phase voltage EB, line current IB. Source inductance same, L. 3 is also conducting, so this is value 3, conducting current I3, and 1 and 3 are conducting, they have common cathode. This is common cathode. This is inductance in series with the load, a heavy inductance, making load current constant and ripple free, and this is the load. And in the lower group, only 2 is conducting. So when load current flows, it completes its path through 2 and flows back through phase C. So this is your value 2. Value 2 is conducting line current I2, the value current I2, which is same as line current IC. This is source inductance L, and this is IC, and this is phase voltage EC. So this is the equivalent circuit. This is positive bus voltage VP, this is negative bus voltage VN. Plus means positive bus, minus means negative bus. And this is the load voltage VD, which is positive bus voltage minus negative bus voltage. Let us try to evaluate this. Now, I can apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, KVL, in this branch. And then I will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, KVL, in this branch. Applying KVL, I can write here, applying KVL, see, I get EA, this voltage minus this voltage drop is equal to positive bus voltage. What is positive bus voltage? It is source voltage EA minus voltage across the inductance. So EA minus, what is the voltage across this inductance? It is LdI1 by dt. EA minus LdI1 by dt is equal to positive bus voltage VP. Let's call this as equation 1. Similarly, if you apply KVL in this branch, EB minus this drop is also equal to VP, because this is also connected to positive bus. So EB minus L di3 by dt is equal to VP. This is equation 2. Let us add the two equations. Adding equations 1 and 2, what do we get? We get EA plus EB minus L d by dt times I1 plus I3. This is left hand side. Is equal to, right on the right hand side, VP plus VP. This plus this. The further simplification gives, now we know that I1 plus I3, and commutation between 1 and 3 is taking place. I1 plus I3 is load current ID, so it is ID, which is absolutely constant current, DC current. So what is, so I can write EA plus EB minus LD, what is I1 plus I3? It is ID, so DID by DT. Is equal to VP plus VP is 2VP. The differentiation of constant is 0, because ID is constant DC current, so its differentiation is 0. So we will get 2VP is equal to EA plus EB. What is EA plus EB? In a balanced three-phase system, EA plus EB plus EC is equal to 0. So EA plus EB is minus EC. So this will give me positive bus voltage VP equal to minus EC by 2. What is negative bus voltage? My value 2 is conducting. You can see in the equivalent circuit also. So negative bus is connected to phase voltage EC. It receives phase voltage EC through value 2. So negative bus voltage, I can write it is equal to EC. So therefore, what is load voltage? Load voltage is positive bus voltage, which is minus EC by 2, minus negative bus voltage, which is EC. It's minus 3 by 2 EC. This is my load voltage. So therefore, in mode 3, that is U greater than 60 degrees, you will either have 4 value conduction or 3 value conduction. Okay, you start with 3 value conduction, followed by 4 value conduction, followed again by 3 value conduction, then 4 value conduction, and so on. So whenever there are 4 value conduction periods, okay, 4 value conduction periods are for U minus 60 degree intervals. For all those U minus 60 degree intervals, load voltage is 0. We have just now established that during 4 value conduction, load voltage is 0. And then for remaining segment of the 60 degrees, from 60 degrees interval, if you subtract this, what you get? You get 120 minus U degrees, for which 3 valves are conducting. So for three valve conduction periods, your load voltage is either minus 1.5, minus 3 by 2 EC, or plus 3 by 2 some other phase voltage, okay, like that. Just like in two and three valve conduction we have seen. So therefore, the conclusion is that for four valve conduction periods or intervals, load receives no voltage, load voltage is zero. And for three valve conduction intervals, load voltage is either minus 3 by 2 times some phase voltage or plus 3 by 2 times some phase voltage. So with this thing in mind, we can now draw the conduction table, and thereafter we can plot the waveforms on the waveform sheets. Let us draw the conduction table. Okay, let us assume, let alpha be equal to 45 degrees for rectification mode and 150 degrees for inversion mode. See, I have not taken in previous class, I have taken alpha 30 degrees. But here, just few moments back, we have come to know if we take EBA as reference, your alpha has to be greater than 30 degrees, because alpha less than 30 degrees means that if you try to fire your value with alpha less than 30 degrees, the commutation voltage across that particular value will be negative, minus. So that value will be reverse biased and it will not fire. So therefore, minimum the lower limit of delay angle is 30 degrees. So your alpha has always to be greater than 30 degrees. So that's why here I have taken alpha 45 degrees, which is greater than 30 degrees. For rectification mode and 150 degrees for inversion mode. And let U be 75 degrees, because we are studying mode 3. In mode 3, U is greater than 60 degrees, and I have taken U 75 degrees, which is greater than 60 degrees. So therefore, if you see three valve conduction will be for how much time? Three valve conduction will be, you can see, or 120 minus U degrees, 120 minus, how much is U? U is 75 degrees, that is 45 degrees, okay? And 4 value conduction will be for how much time? 4 value conduction will be for U minus 60 degrees. U is how much? 75 minus 60 degrees, that is 15 degrees. So therefore, whenever you in the table find 4 valves conducting, they will conduct only for 15 degrees, and whenever you see three valves are conducting, they will conduct for 45 degrees. So I will write here, four valve conduction is for, as per this, is for 15 degrees, and three valve conduction as per this is 45 degrees. So with this in mind, let us draw the conduction table now. Before drawing the waveforms, we have to draw the conduction table. So this is our table. First column is conducting valves. Conducting valves. From to the load voltage VD, and finally last column is value voltage V3. Again, I will draw the voltage across value 3. Value 3 we have been taking as a reference value in previous lectures also, so I will continue. But in the examinations, you can be asked to draw the voltage across any value. So you can try, when you draw the waveforms, you can try for value 3 voltage, or you can try for drawing voltage of any other value, okay? Conducting valves will be, let us start with the firing of value 3. So 4 value conduction, 6, 1, 2, 3. That means 3 is fired here. When 3 is fired, it will, previously 6, 1, 2, 3 valves were conducting, and now after alpha electrical degrees, firing pulse has been issued to value 3. It goes into conduction and commutation between 1 and 3 starts. So it gives 6, 1, 2, 3, 4 value conduction. Now this 4 value conduction will be followed by 3 value conduction, and commutation between 6 and 2 is over, 6 is out, 2 is in. So this is 3 value conduction, 1, 2, 3. Then which valve is fired? Value 4 is fired. I will show here firing pulse issued to value 4. And when value 4 is fired, commutation between 2 and 4 will start. 2 is already conducting, so this will give 4 valve conduction. 1, 2, 3, 4. this four valve conduction will be followed by three valve conduction when commutation between one and three is over. One is out, three is in, two, three. So you can continue like this, then value five is fired. Two, three, four, five is four value conduction, followed by three value conduction, three, four, five. Then value six is fired, three, four, five, six. Followed by three value conduction, four, five, six. Then value one is fired. 4561, then 3 value conduction 561, then value 2 is fired. 5612, 612, and then value 3 is again fired. You reach back. Okay, from what is alpha, what is delay angle? Just few moments back, I have written for rectification mode of operation, alpha is 45 degrees. Because alpha has to be greater than 30 degrees. And for inversion mode of operation, we have assumed alpha 150 degrees. And we have assumed u, since u is greater than 60 degrees, we have assumed u 75 degrees. So therefore, 3 is fired after a delay of 45 degrees for rectification mode and 150 degrees for inversion mode. And it gives 4 value conduction. And you can see 4 value conduction lasts for u minus 60 degrees, that is 15 degrees only. So 45 plus 15 is 60 degrees, oblique 150 plus 15 is 165 degrees. So I will come to this column later on. Let's complete this first. Then 3 value conduction is from 60 degrees, oblique 165 degrees, that is this, to 3 value conduction lasts for 45 degrees. So 60 plus 45 means 105 degrees, oblique 210 degrees. Okay, then value 4 is fired, it gives 4 value conduction 1, 2, 3, 4 from 105 degrees for rectification mode, oblique 210 degrees for inversion mode to 15 degrees because 4 value conduction is only for 15 degrees. 105 plus 15 is 120 degrees, oblique 210 plus 15 is 225 degrees. Then 3 value conduction will be followed from 120 degrees, oblique 225 degrees to 120 plus 45 is 165 degrees, oblique 225 plus 45, 270 degrees. Then value 5 is fired and you again get 4 value conduction from 165 degrees, oblique 270 degrees to 165 plus 15 is 180 degrees by 275 plus 15, 285 degrees. So you can continue like this. And 180 degrees oblique 285 degrees, 325 degrees oblique 330 degrees, then 325 degrees oblique 330 degrees to 340 degrees. I'm sorry, this is 225 degrees. Not 325 degrees. So this is 240 degrees for rectification mode, oblique 345 degrees for inversion mode. Then 240 degrees, oblique 345 degrees, 245, add 45 more. So this is 285 degrees. 345 plus 45 means 390. 390 means 30 degrees. Because your cycle ends at 360 degrees. So this means 30 degrees. Then 285 degrees oblique 30 degrees to add 15 degrees more. So this is 300 degrees oblique 45 degrees. Then 3 value conductions from 300 degrees oblique 45 degrees to 45 degrees more. And 45 degrees, so 300 to 345 degrees for rectification mode, and 45 plus 45 means 90 degrees for inversion mode, and finally 4 value conduction 345 degrees oblique 90 degrees. This is 345 plus 15 means 360 degrees, oblique 90 plus 15 means 105 degrees. And lastly, three value conduction is like this, 360 degrees, oblique 150 degrees. For three value conduction is therefore 45 degrees. 360 plus 45 means 45 itself. 45 degrees, oblique 105 plus 45 means 150 degrees. So you have reached back to this, 45 oblique 150, and here you again fire value 3. So this is our firing range for various values, 4 value conduction followed by 3 value conduction, then 4, 3 and so on. What about load voltage? We have started with the firing of value 3 and use 4 value conduction, 6.23. And we already know that whenever 4 valves are conducting, your load is shorted by 4 valves and load voltage is 0. So this is 0. And now 4 value conduction is followed by 3 value conduction for 45 degrees. And which 3 valves are conducting? 1, 2, 3. 1 and 3 in the upper group and 2 in the lower group is conducting. And you use the same trick which we have used for 2 and 3 value conduction. 1 and 3 in the upper group of valves is conducting. Which valve is not conducting? 5. And 5 is connected to phase voltage EC. So load voltage is minus 1.5 times EC. Okay. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, 4 value conduction with the firing of value 4. So during 4 value conduction, load voltage is 0 again. Then 3 value conduction again, 2, 3, 4, 2 and 4 in the lower group, 3 in the upper group, 2 and 4 are conducting in the lower group, which value is not connected? 6, 6 is connected to phase voltage EB, so it is 1 plus 1.5 times EB. Then again 4 value conduction with the firing of value 5, so 0, then 4 value conduction is followed by 3 value conduction, 3, 4, 5. 3 and 5 are conducting, 1 is not conducting, load voltage is minus 1.5 EA. Then again 4 value conduction 0. Okay, then you can take just phase opposite of this. What was the load voltage when 1, 2, 3 were conducting? Minus 1.5 EC. So when 4, 5, 6 are conducting, it is plus 1.5 EC. You can find it from diagram also, but you can just remember it like then 4 value conduction 0, then this is plus 1.5 EB, this will be minus 1.5 EB. And again 0, and this is minus 1.5 EA, this is plus 1.5 EA. So this completes our this column, 1, 2, 3, fourth column, load voltage. And finally we have voltage across the value 3 voltage column. See, value 3 is conducting here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 7 intervals, value 3 is conducting. And as long as value 3 is conducting, voltage across it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 7 intervals, load value voltage is 0. Then 4, 5, 6 are conducting. 4, 5, 6 are conducting. That means 4 and 6 in the bottom and 5 in the upper. 5 in the upper group is conducting, means its cathode voltage is EC. And 4 and 6 in lower group means its anode voltage is EA plus EB. That is minus EC by 2. So minus EC by 2 minus EC is minus 3 by 2 EC, that is minus 1.5 EC, and that you can find from here also. I have told you in 2 and 3 value conduction also, if load voltage is plus 1.5 EC, your value voltage just take opposite of minus 1.5 EC. And when 4 values are conducting, whenever there is 4 value conduction, value voltage is 0. We can see that from the circuit diagram itself. See, 4, 5, 6, 1 are conducting. 5 is conducting, 1 is conducting, 4 is conducting, 6 is also conducting. So value 3, voltage across value 3 automatically becomes 0. So 0. And then when 3 valves are conducting, that's 5, 6, 1, what is your load voltage? Minus 1.5 EB, and your value voltage will be plus 1.5 EB. Then again value voltage is 0, and then value voltage is opposite of this, minus 1.5 EA. This completes your conduction table. And with this table, we can now go to the waveform sheet and we can draw waveforms for both rectification mode of operation as well as for inversion mode of operation for mode 3.